So, I mean, there's two questions is, you know, that I just ask you to think about in response to that is what do you actually need the missions for that can't be provided by other groups, right? And then second is just to recognize, I think what's a little bit different than Dennis's position is, you know, he's a great scientist within global health, but he's within that bureaucracy. Our office is directly tied to the administrator of aid. Our institute is being launched by the President of the United States. The development labs are kind of some of the most important things that we're doing. So don't, you know, the first thing is you shouldn't put yourself in a position where you would be dependent on the missions for success, right?
No.
Because this is coming directly from, you know, the administrators. The number one reform priority for the agency is around science and technology. And understanding that is critical. And we're, you know, I met the mission last week to specifically talk to them. They're really excited about the innovations and what we're trying to do and how we're trying to do it. But also, you know, so I think one is it's a different situation. Two is we can obviously look at integrating not only across missions, but of course, other parts of aid in what we're trying to do. But three, you shouldn't put yourself in a position where you feel that that is necessary for your success, because if you're actually taking a bottom-up approach, it doesn't have to be a limiting factor in terms of what we're trying to do. So, but we're keen to help with that piece.
Then the other question that I read the mail, and this mail was talking about travel, visa. I don't know that that's been really.
It's too broad, right?
No, travel.
Oh, for the university professors from the United States coming and faculty.
And
yes, like if Jeannie comes here, right.
You know, I don't know whether it's not that simple in some countries getting visas.
No, it's not. Successfully.
And what we have done here, if we are working with people, we work with the Internal Affairs, and the Minister of Internal Affairs confirmed that you come to this meeting because we told you this is that country. Is interesting. But getting a visa from the U.S. Embassy, and they have put this clause that you should have a J visa, I think it's going to be a very big problem. I know that through RESPOND, we have had people for the universities we are working with, since I'm coordinating it, as I talk by the Minnesota and Tufts, they were supposed to be people, I think five people were made their visas in their countries. And these are the same countries we're working with. So if we have that description that people will travel for their visas when they already have US visas, I think I look at it as going to be a hindrance. Somebody who has had an attempt to get a J visa and they have had problems, he will not offer himself to participate because he already has a U.S. visa. Now to go through the laborious process of getting a new visa, I see that as something that you could discuss. People have visas. Why necessarily people get a visa?
I think that's a
great
point.
I've never heard about it, but I saw this email, and I imagine if it came before we came there last month, when we came the last time, then was with it.
So my, you know, if people already have visas, then I don't think it's necessary to get other visas, and we can look at it. And then to the extent that you're having trouble with the visa processes, one of the things I think that we can do is I have very good relations with the State Department and our Office of the Science Advisor there. And so, you know, aid is actually technically part of state. We can work with them to try to influence things from Washington, only if there's problems, but we'll look into the J visa situation. I think you're right that if someone has an existing valid visa that is good for the duration of the project or for, you know, the first couple of years, we shouldn't ask for people to go through the expense and cost and difficulty of doing that. So that makes sense.
And of course, the other question that we may have, we will discuss them with Kathleen if they're there. Team. pass them on over to you. Because I do not expect that you'd ask this, but to me as a leader, if those two are done, I think most of the things we are set right. Of course, the work plan, we have worked with her and the team, we are comfortable and we'll have the work plan out and we'll be running. And the next thing is that we shall we'll have good reports from her. And maybe this last one.
You can ask anything you want.
Maybe this last one. You see, we do not want to be selfish in Uganda. We are privileged that you have come for this debate. And you are going to launch this. But if we have a lab in Uganda, I'm not sure the travel approvals for Catherine and the other people of the team. I think other labs would allow to see the people we work with in USAID. So that they do not only need them when we have the steering meeting or partners meeting here, but they should participate. Say, for example, we are going to have training in Ethiopia, or in Somalia, or in Southern Sudan. Our people will be there. We would request that USAID personnel participate in this camp.
Yeah.
So that people see, because if you are in my situation, and we keep coming to our country, Uganda comes. How about USAID? We say USAID is supporting. So if you can ask politely that you allow this, I don't know how many travel approvals they have or to participate in the different labs, so that it is seen as real partnership, not as.
We will absolutely do what we can, because I think the best thing for the strength of this is actually engagement in what we're trying to do. We do have some challenges right now. Our Congress is, there's something called sequestration,
yes,
which is an automatic across-the-board cut in all the agencies. And one of the things that has been cut, it has been substantially, has been travel. So we're dealing with those regulations. And, you know, it's a question of, do we cut a trip or do we actually fire someone? And that's actually the decision. So everyone has agreed, okay, we have to make decisions.